mountain. Looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Went down into the deepest valley. Looked all around down there, couldn't find nobody. I went across the deep blue sea. Couldn't find one to compare to your grace, your love, your mercy. Nobody greater than you. Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater, no. Nobody greater than you. Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater than you. Nobody can heal like you can. Oh, most holy one, you are the great I am. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. You are he who carried out redemption's plan. You are he who carried out redemption's plan.
Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody.
Nobody great. Well, well, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name.
Amen. Praise Hallelujah. The Lord, saints of God. Praise the Lord, Antioch. Amen.
God bless y'all. Thank y'all for coming this morning. It's good to see everybody coming online.
Yes.
And leaders, if y'all in the house, if y'all in the city, y'all could drop on by. We good this morning.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Good to see the Neals are in the house this morning. Drove all the way in. Amen. From Southfield, Michigan, and just drove all the way in on this morning. So we thank God for you. Love you guys so much. Greg Millen is in the house today. Amen. God bless you. Happy birthday to you, my brother. Happy birthday to you, man. Good to see you. Hallelujah. There's Carolyn Terry's in the house today.
Good morning,
Hallelujah.
Sister Terry.
Thank you so much. Amen. Thank y'all so much for coming. It's so good to see everybody coming in and all you guys are starting to chime in this morning on this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Sunday morning. Beautiful Sunday morning. If you are not in Michigan, the sun is shining brightly outside.
Yes,
amen.
It's going to be a beautiful
what they
day.
Say, this is the day that the Lord has made. This is one. This is a God day.
Amen.
Amen. Ain't this a God day?
Hey, you wake up and you know God is still in charge. He's still on the throne.
He is still on the throne. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
And he's got you. Praise God.
He got you. Amen.
Amen.
Go ahead, First Lady.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And welcome again to our online real-time service. We are doing both today.
Yeah.
Amen. We have people in the sanctuary as well as having our live Facebook service as well. So we just want to welcome all of you as we come together to worship and hear a powerful, mighty word of God so that we can be encouraged to do the things that God is calling us to do.
Amen. We're transitioning back, and we're transitioning back a little bit slowly. I'm more of a conservative kind of a person. Amen. And so we're going to transition back a little bit slowly. So this week, the leaders are coming back. Next week, the leaders are coming back.
Amen.
And then on And then on Easter Sunday, everybody's coming back.
Which
amen.
Is April 4th.
April 4th.
Then we will be open to the public.
To the amen. Public. Amen. Hallelujah.
So bring your babies. Come on in and just let's have a great Easter, Resurrection Sunday, whatever you want to call it. All we know is that Jesus got up and we celebrate that. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So you know, I have to say though, Pastor,
yeah.
It's been 365 days.
Wow.
And to be able to look out and see the leaders, see them face to face. Of course, we have our mask on. We are social distancing. We have sanitizing stations.
Yes.
So we have everything covered. But it is so good to just lay eyes on the saints of God. Amen.
Amen. And it's been a journey. It has
yes.
been a journey. And we've been talking about that. We talked about it on last week. Me and you have been talking about it since day one, really.
Amen.
But really over the last couple of weeks, we've really been talking about how far we have come and how far God has brought us.
My God.
Amen. When you think about last year, this time, and you think about the amount of anxiety that
Amen.
Was on people, and people, listen, this wasn't no joke. People were dying. People were dying.
Yes.
This was not a joke. Amen.
Amen.
And so we were, you know, we all took it very, very seriously.
And so, you like, Sister Simon.
And so now,
good morning.
Now to see people starting to travel again, starting to see people begin to go to different places again, and people are coming back to work even.
Yes.
People are going back to school.
Amen.
People are getting their vaccines. Amen. Somebody asked me, they said, Pastor, do you support the vaccine? Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yes.
I said, absolutely.
Amen.
I support the vaccine. Yes, I do.
Amen.
I do. I love orange soda. I do. That's for my millennials. My millennials, they know that one. Amen. But yes, I do support the vaccine, and I am so grateful. And I just want to while I got the mic on that, I want to send a shout out to the city of Detroit for what they did with that vaccine. They have been awesome.
They went to work.
They have been awesome.
They have been a great example of how to get it done.
How to get that thing done.
Amen.
They get it. So anyway, all right, First Lady, go to work.
Amen. So just want to remind you that we are kingdom seekers at Antioch. We are empowered by love.
Edified by faith.
And committed to excellence.
Amen.
So let's get right to the psalm here. Psalms 139:14. I'm just going to camp out there because this is Women's History Month. And I just think that this is such a beautiful psalm as
yes.
a reminder to women that we are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image and likeness of God.
Yes.
As women, sometimes we can feel a little overwhelmed.
Yes.
We can feel underappreciated.
Yes.
But God says, I will praise you, O God, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, calling us wonderful. He's calling us wonderful.
Amen.
And we have to agree with that. And it says, this my soul knows well. And we know that the soul is the mind, the will, and the emotion. So we have to agree with God that he has said that we are wonderful.
Yes.
We are fearfully and wonderfully made. And so as I reflect on Women's History Month today, we celebrate so many firsts, Madam C.J. Walker, Madam Vice President Kamala Harris, and so many others. But I want to just focus on the women of Antioch today, because as I look back, Pastor, over this year, it has been an amazing year. It has been a challenge, and yet I've seen God move in such a mighty way. And I just want to start, I kick it off with Sister Loretta Baker, who started the charge for the prayer. We started with doing 100 days of prayer, and now here we are, a year later, and we are still going strong with our prayer. And I just want to just honor her for that as she led her team over this year.
Yeah.
I also want to honor our finance team,
yeah.
Sister Sandra Butler
yeah.
and Sister Dorothy Wilson,
yeah.
Who have over the year, you guys, they have not missed a beat.
Not one beat.
On taking care of the financial accounting for the church. I know many churches do not have that testimony. Many businesses, small businesses don't have that. And so for us to be able to say that that has continued to happen, I want to just celebrate them. I also want to celebrate, of course, Petra Waters and Carol and Terry, who have led our team of volunteers for the Charles Terry Pantry.
Yes.
To serve our community month after month.
Yes.
And I tell you, the timing of that pantry, I still look back and say, look at God, because the timing of that pantry was right at the time of COVID.
My, my.
And we were there to help the community. I also just want to give a shout out to Linda Shears, who she has made so many masks, hundreds if not thousands of masks. And I mean, they are beautiful. They're two-sided. We have themes. We have all these things. But she wanted those masks to be available for the community. And then I could not stop until I gave a shout out to Paula Simon, who has consistently been there for our families in their time of loss.
My God.
And of their loved ones.
Oh, say that. Say that.
Because as we all know, over the last year, we've seen too many, Pastor, too many people going.
I know.
And she has just been there
and
just so devoted and dedicated. And I just want to honor, again, we can honor a lot of people.
Yes.
But we have to remember to honor the people in our midst. And I just say thank you, and I love all of you so much. I'll be doing more shout-outs next week. But I just want us as women to remember that we are worth celebrating.
Yes,
we truly are worth celebrating. God has called us wonderful.
My God.
And so we have to remember to agree with God, no matter how you might be feeling today. Know that you are wonderful and that you are loved with an everlasting love. Amen.
Amen. You know, I was raised in the house with women.
Yes.
You do know that, don't you?
I do know that.
You know, when daddy be at work,
they was getting you ready for me.
I know. No, hey, I was about to say, you are a recipient. I was going to say, you are a recipient.
Yes, I am.
Of me being raised by them women in my house.
I get it.
Amen. First lady say, hey, Ed, would you look in my purse? No, I ain't looking in no purse. Bring me my purse. No, I ain't bringing you no purse. Hey, because in my house, you did not touch them ladies' purses.
With the purse.
And you certainly didn't look in there or go in there. You looking in my purse. No, ain't nobody looking in your purse. I want nothing to do with your purse.
Amen.
Y'all ain't saying nothing. My sister out there, she know I'm telling the truth.
Praise God.
You do not look in mama's purse. And mama's purse, my mother's purse weighed about 75 pounds. My mama's purse weighed about 75 pounds.
Right.
My mama say, somebody say, man, you know what? I need to hem a gown, or I need to hem something. Mama say, bring me my purse.
It's in there.
Somebody say, I just bust my head. My mama say, bring me my purse. She had stitches. Them little butterfly stitches. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
She had everything in the purse.
Yes.
Amen.
Because you never know.
Snacks.
Right?
Snacks.
Because you never know what you might need.
I ain't going to say nothing. Rest in peace, Mama. Mama might have had some plastic bags in her purse, little Glad bags, just in case we went to the restaurant. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
That's enough.
Leave me alone. Just in case we went to the restaurant. We get home. Y'all get hungry. Y'all be hungry lately. Mom, did you grab some of that chicken? Yeah, I got some. Glory be to God. I'm sorry. I just digress a little. Amen. Yes. Mothers. Great mothers. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, you ready to pray?
Amen.
All right.
Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you and praise you for this day. This truly is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and we will be glad in this day. We honor you. We adore you. We magnify you. We lift up your holy and righteous name.
Hallelujah.
Today.
Come on, pray with
Hallelujah.
Us.
Hallelujah. We are in awe of you, God, because you have kept us.
Come on,
for
pray with
365
us.
365 days.
Oh, thank you,
God.
Jesus.
We say thank you.
Thank
for
you,
that.
Father. Thank you, Lord God.
You are mighty. Hallelujah.
You are mighty, God.
You are our God. You are our Father, our provider, our protector.
Yes, thank you, Father.
You are our provision, God, today.
Thank you, Father.
And we thank you today,
we give you glory today, Lord God.
That you love us unconditionally.
We honor you today, Lord God.
And always, God.
Hallelujah.
And that you call us fearfully and wonderfully made.
Yes, Lord.
In your image and likeness, Father.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Father, for Jesus, our Lord and Savior.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You, Father.
We thank you for the Holy Spirit, our leader and our guide. And we thank you for the word, the power of the word mixed with faith, hallelujah, that can move mountains.
Yes,
hallelujah. God.
We thank
you today,
thank you,
Father.
Lord God.
We thank you, Father God, for those that will come to know you or be challenged to go higher in you today,
my
Lord God.
God.
We thank you for
yes.
that, Father God.
Hallelujah.
Move our hearts, Father, right now.
Come on, wherever you are. Come
Let
on, lift
know,
your hand,
Father
lift
God.
Your hand, lift your hand, lift
hallelujah,
your hand. Come on, just come on, just touch him.
To make your abode
oh,
them,
thank you,
God.
Father. Hallelujah.
That you want to rest in them.
Oh.
Rule and abide
bless
and
you.
Guide in them, Father God.
Oh, we bless you.
We praise you right now,
yes.
Lord God, for those that will come to know
yes,
you
yes, yes,
as
yes.
Lord and Savior.
My God.
We pray for our pastor today, Father, as he brings a powerful, anointed,
ooh.
Life-changing word. Hallelujah.
Oh, bless your name.
We thank you right now, Father.
Right now, Lord.
That you're stirring up the gift inside
stir it
of
up.
Him. Hallelujah.
Stir it up.
We thank you, God.
Stir it
Speak
up.
Through your man today.
Yes.
Like never before.
Like
Father.
Never before.
And Father God, you know what's going on all over this globe.
Yes, Lord.
You know, Father God.
My God.
And so we're going to speak a word of faith.
Yes.
And we know that the best is still yet to come.
Come
Father
on,
God.
Somebody say that out loud. The best
Father,
is yet to come.
Come
on. Father, you
and
kept
we will
us. Thank
not
you, Lord God.
That, Father,
you're a keeper.
God. We say
Fixer.
Thank you.
Fixer.
Be with every household.
Yes,
be with
Lord.
Every person, Lord God, under the sound of my voice, no matter what continent they're on, Lord
yes,
God.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
We ask that you will take good care of them.
Yes,
as
Lord.
As only you know how to do, Daddy.
Mama.
We thank you right now,
right
Father
now,
God.
Lord.
Bless each and every one.
Yes.
Every need be met, Father
yes.
God. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
let
name.
Let every heart say amen.
Amen. Somebody
hallelujah.
Say amen and thank God. Come
amen.
On, y'all. Let's give God a hand clap of praise
hallelujah.
Wherever you are.
Glory,
come on, give him some praise
glory.
Wherever you are.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He is
thank
worthy
you,
to
God.
Be praised. Hallelujah.
Holy,
from the rising
holy,
of the sun
the
to the
God
going
Almighty.
Down of the same, he is worthy to
earth.
Be praised. I thank God that he's a cool. forgiving God. Amen.
Yes, yes.
How many people know that he is a forgiving God?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He is a forgiving
thank
God,
you, God,
loving God, kind
thank
God.
You.
Hallelujah.
My
so
God.
We just thank you for that. Hallelujah. Well, let's come on. Let's do some announcements and then we will get down to the word. I'm ready.
Amen.
I'm ready for the word. I'm ready for the
word
today. Amen. So God
Amen.
Bless each and every one of you today. Thank y'all so much for coming. And thank you for celebrating March birthdays.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, first lady. Who got some?
So
who?
On the first, we had Amelia Johnson
yes.
and PJ or Pam.
Right.
We had Brian Jackson celebrated in early March.
Yes.
Jennifer Haywood, Sandra Gordon on the 18th.
Yes.
Eugenia Johnson just had a birthday. Destiny Thomas, our daughter in love.
Yeah.
And you said Greg Millen, when is his birthday?
Greg was yesterday.
Okay, so happy birthday, Greg, for yesterday.
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Destiny, for
today.
Today.
It's her birthday today.
Today. Happy
yeah.
birthday. We love you.
Yeah.
And Peter Thomas on the 24th.
Yep, that's
we
my cousin.
We have Grace Wembley and Latoya Leak on the 27th.
Yes.
So happy birthday to all of our March birthdays.
Happy birthday to all of you all. Amen.
Amen.
God bless y'all. God
Amen.
Bless y'all. It is so good to celebrate
oh, hey
a birthday.
Destiny, I see her out there. Happy birthday, baby.
Happy birthday, Des.
Amen.
It is so good to celebrate a birthday. Amen.
Yes.
And listen,
the blessing.
Last year it was a challenge to celebrate the birthdays because of COVID. And we
yes.
kind of used to it now. And we used to like doing drive-bys. And we got real creative with things. But it was a challenge to celebrate our birthdays on last year. So I say to each and every one of you all, happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Amen.
And so glad that you are celebrating another birthday. Amen.
Amen.
Listen, Easter Sunday, in 2 weeks, our in-person service returns. Amen.
Amen.
Make sure you got your mask on. Amen. We've
Lighten
got
up,
we've,
please have a mask on. Amen.
We've got the pews have been partitioned off, so we have social distance in between each pew, amen. Families will be allowed to sit together. We will open up the entire church with the fellowship hall as well, so people will be allowed to sit on the fellowship hall side. And we're just going to spread out and
amen.
Just enjoy
we
the Lord,
the space,
amen.
Which is
we've got the space. God has really blessed us with space. He gave us 22,000 square feet, amen.
Amen.
And so we thank God for that. for a time. Watch this, y'all. Such as this.
Come on, man.
Amen. Such as this. So we ready for you. Come on. Amen. Bring your kids with the Easter dresses. Amen. I saw some beautiful Easter dresses. Remember, when we went shopping the other day, and those were some beautiful Easter dresses with all the ruffles and stuff. Amen.
I just love it.
So
I
bring
love
your
it.
Easter, bring them with the Easter dresses. Amen. And then bring them with their and let them have those Easter suits. Amen. Ain't nothing like a little Easter suit.
Oh, yeah.
Ain't nothing like a little Easter
so
suit.
Cute.
Amen.
So
the little brown boy. The little brown boy, Tressa's son, that joker be having some suits, amen? And I don't know where they get them suits from, but he be sharp as a tack every Easter, amen? Hallelujah. So we thank God for each and every one of you all. And don't forget about the pantry.
Yes.
The pantry is going to be on April 3rd.
That's April
Saturday, 3rd. April 3rd. April 3rd.
And
from
Easter Sunday is Sunday,
April
4th.
But the pantry is April 3rd, 12 to 2. If you're going to be dropping your donations off, drop them off at 11:30. Amen.
Amen.
Drop them off at 11:30. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we thank God for that. And then also, don't forget the prayer line. The prayer line is on Tuesday at 6 a.m. and Tuesday at 6 p.m. The 6 p.m. one got added about a year ago because of the pandemic.
Amen.
And so we still operate that one. And so if you don't catch 6 a.m., you can definitely catch 6 p.m. Amen. So come on out for the 6 p.m. service. And we only go 10 minutes. Amen. And the one at 6 p.m., it'd be a whole lot of laughing.
Yes.
They don't be doing a whole lot of laughing at 6 a.m., but at 6 p.m., they be just laughing.
Yeah.
Everybody be up and just loving on each other. Amen. So hallelujah. So make sure that you join one of those. If you got shut out, if you have never joined one of the prayers, just keep looking straight ahead. Don't just keep looking straight ahead. Look at your phone, look at the wall, whatever. Don't get shut out. Call the prayer line. Prayer changes things.
Yes, it does.
Amen. I'm telling y'all something. It was prayer that got us through the pandemic.
Amen.
Y'all don't, man, it was prayer.
Amen.
When we was called, that 6 o'clock, woo, that 6 p.m. prayer line was blowing up.
It was like
one time we had about 50-some people on that prayer line.
It was like
I said, these folks is scared.
Enough.
Folks is scared. Folks is reaching to God.
Amen.
They was reaching to God saying,
amen,
you got to get me through this. Amen.
Amen. Praise the
and
Lord.
So we just thank God for prayer. Amen.
Amen.
So don't forget about the Lord now. I said, don't forget about the Lord now.
What
amen.
Did Jesus say to the 10 lepers that were healed?
Yeah.
He said, were there not 10?
Were there not 10?
And only one said thank you.
And only one came back and
come
said
on.
Thank you. All right, don't forget.
God is due.
We start our Wednesday Bible study, restarts again. I took a couple week break, Liz Newberry. I took a couple weeks, amen, try to refresh my battery just a little bit. Sometimes I even pass, is that her cup? She gave you that cup. And sometimes
bless
I even, I even Superman get tired sometimes, amen, and need to take a break, amen. So
amen.
I just took me a little break. I've been going 52 weeks. I've been going since this pandemic.
Yes.
I have not taken a Sunday off. Y'all do know that, right?
Amen.
I haven't taken a Sunday off. And y'all do know I haven't had like a traditional anniversary in about 3 years. Y'all do know that too, right? Amen. I'm just
amen.
Telling y'all. I'm just saying.
Amen.
Amen. Don't forget about your pastor.
Amen.
Don't forget about me. Amen. All right. Y'all ready to roll?
All right.
It is giving time. It's giving time. The Bible says, given it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shake it together, running over. Watch this, what it says. Men shall do what?
Give into your bosom.
Give into your bosom. Hallelujah. It's better to give, y'all, than it is to even receive. Amen.
Amen.
I thank God for you. And I say this every week. I've been saying this every week during this pandemic that you guys, I love y'all so much. Y'all have given throughout this pandemic. The giving has increased. It has not decreased because you understand the law of sowing and reaping. Amen.
Amen.
Nobody want to cut their flow off. Hallelujah. I'm watching the clock. Nobody wants to cut their flow off. Amen. And so listen, so if you are sowing your seed today through Cash App, it's a money sign, A-N-T-I-O-C-H, 5430. Also, if you use Cash App, all you got to do now is just go up and click on Antioch Church. And then all you got to do is just type in offering or tithe or whatever you put in that subject line.
Yes.
And you're good to go. Amen.
Amen.
And then put your total, your number in that you're sending. And then for those that send through PayPal, people still sow through PayPal. You could do that. But via the website, go to the website, www.antiochoflansing.org. Amen. And you can click on giving and it will take you right through the prompts. Or if you're old school and just still like to write a check.
Come on.
Amen. Hallelujah.
That's all right.
Hallelujah. Too. I don't know if my uncle is here today, but when my uncle got ready to get his retirement, I don't know that is Charlie on today. But my uncle, when he got ready to get his retirement, he told them he wanted his first retirement check in a check. He said he wanted a physical check.
I bet the payroll department.
Y'all ain't saying that. He wanted a physical check. He said, "I want me to give me a physical check." And then he said, "Then y'all can start depositing into my account."
If you decide to do that, you can mail it to P.O.
Box. P.O.
Box 80346, Lansing, Michigan 48908.
Thank you so much
Any
for that.
Any way you give.
Thank you so much for that, First Lady, because,
we'll
you know.
We'll be thankful. Amen.
I start drifting. I feel like telling stories today. I'm a storyteller. I feel like telling some stories today. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to have to reach back and get some of them old good old stories. Amen. All right. Come on. Just wave your offering at me. Say, Father God, say thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, y'all. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Y'all know, we know what to do. Father God, thank you.
Thank you.
For blessing me.
For blessing me.
With this seed.
With this seed.
I sow my seed.
I sow my seed.
By faith.
By faith.
And I fully expect.
And I fully expect.
A 100-fold return.
A 100-fold return.
On my giving.
On my giving.
Lord.
Lord.
I live. To give.
To give.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank
Come
you
on.
God.
You got to put something in the ground.
Thank
Amen.
You, Lord.
Listen, you got to put something in the ground. If you're watching, if you're watching me today, put
Lord
something
God.
In the ground. Do a cash app. I'm not telling you what to sow
Hallelujah.
Today. I will tell you this, though, that God always blesses that $20 seed in this house. But I'm not telling you what to sow. You sow whatever you want to sow. Amen.
Amen.
But by all means, sow something. Amen.
Amen.
Sow something. Put a seed in the ground. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, y'all ready for the word?
Praise
I
God.
Say, are y'all ready for the word?
All right, Pastor. I'll see you Amen. On the other side.
I see you, baby. Come on back. Come on back. Come on back. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, turn with me to Luke chapter number 4. Thanks, First Lady. Luke chapter number 4. You're looking good, too. And verse number 17 through 20. Luke chapter number 4. We're going to take a look at verse 17 through 20. 17 through 20. Amen. Hallelujah. I see a lot of my leaders out there on Facebook today. Y'all know y'all could have came in here today. Amen. Hallelujah. Luke chapter number 4, 17 through 20. 17 through 20. 17 through 20. That's one of the things that Paula, I've been telling the college that even though when we go back face to face to start teaching classes again, we're still going to have an online component because everybody is not going to come back face to face. And the same thing with church, we're still going to have this online component because everybody is not ready to come into the house of the Lord yet. Amen. And so that's going to be a very important component for folks to have. Did y'all find Luke chapter number 4? Are y'all ready? Hallelujah. Let's read. And it was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he have anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. And he have sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, the recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And then he closed the book, and he gave it again to the minister. And he sat down, and the eyes of all them that were in the synagogue were fastened on him. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for your word. We pray, Lord God, that your word lights up the path of the believer. Father God, I pray, Lord God, none of me, but I pray, Lord God, all of thee on today. Pray for the hearers, Lord God, whether they face to face or whether, Lord God, they are on Facebook. I pray for them today. And I pray, Lord God, that you would just touch their hearts in a special way today. Guide them, Lord God. Drop this word deep into their hearts, Lord God. Father God, and I pray, Lord God, none of me, but I pray, Lord God, all of thee. We'll be quick to give you the glory, the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name, let every heart say amen. Now, before you sit down, shake that Bible. It's good to say that. It is good to say that. It's good to say, it's good to say before you sit down. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I got to preach real good because my mother-in-law just came in. And amen. She just came in, so I'm going to have to preach real good. Before you sit down, say, this is my word. Say, if I receive this word with my mind only, then this word is dead to me. But if I receive this word with my spirit over my mind, then this word is life to me. I do not need any religious form or fashion. I need life in Jesus' name. Amen. I need somebody, before you sit down, just say this out loud. Good is new. Say it again. Good is new. Put that on in the chat line, somebody. Good as new. Good as new. Good as new. Hallelujah. Be seated in the presence of the Lord if you can. Hallelujah. Be seated if you can. This quarter, we have been teaching and preaching on guarding our hearts. Guarding our hearts. Paul Simon, would you just say amen? Amen. Thank you. I just want to hear your voice. Amen. I just want to hear your voice. You know, we got the mask on and you can't see if people are smiling. We're going to have to get some cards, some smiley cards, or we're going to have to get a card with a praise the Lord hand or something on it so we'll know what's going on. Amen. Because you can't see if folks are smiling or nothing, you know. Y'all can see me. Amen. And I got my Lysol up here, and you know, so that when I get done preaching, I spray my germs out. So we've been preaching and teaching on guarding our hearts. Guarding our hearts. Today I want to preach from this thought: good as new. Good as new. I feel good today. Good as new. Last week or so, the Christian community was enamored by the brokenness within gospel recording artist Kurt Franklin's family. Kurt Franklin has children by his current wife, but he also has a child from a previous relationship. And Franklin, for those that don't know, he's a gospel recording artist, and he's been out for a very long time. And he got into a heated argument with one of his grown children. It was a grown son. And Kurt Franklin cussed that dude out. I mean, he cussed him out. He put some combos together. Ante, he put some combos together. Many in the secular world were outraged at us, the Christian community, because they wanted the Christian community to cancel Kurt. Y'all not saying nothing to me. We live in a world today that folks call the cancel culture. And what the cancel culture means is that when we don't like something about someone, we dismiss them. When we don't like something about someone, we throw them away, no matter how much good they have done in their careers. Deacon Neal, we throw them away. Kurt Franklin quickly came out and apologized for his actions. But there was some under rumblings that were going on. Some of the under rumblings was, look at him. Ain't he supposed to be a Christian? Y'all know how folk do us. Y'all know how the worldly folks do us. Come on, somebody.
Aha! I got you. I told y'all about them so-called Christians. Y'all gonna leave me alone today? They ain't all that. Hey, see that? See, look what he did. Come on, somebody. I knew they was like that. But here it is right here. Many folks in the Christian community, we were not hurt by what Kurt said. We weren't even disappointed. And the truth be told, we weren't even offended. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. Kurt language didn't offend us. Some even came out and questioned his need to apologize. I'm going to preach this thing, y'all. And they said, wait a minute. What is his son doing putting his personal business in the streets? The question is that we're pondering today is, why didn't the Christian community cancel Kurt? I believe that the real truth, especially during this year of COVID, is that most of us Christians can attest to the words of Grandmaster Flash, who said, don't push me, because I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my hair, but it's a jungle. Sometimes it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. That means that all of us are a work in progress. That means, listen, I wish I had some real fun. That means that many of us are one prayer away from going off on you. Many saved folks, we just one prayer away. Mm-hmm. Some of us then caught a whole bunch of cuss in the mouth. You're just lucky it didn't come out. Religious leaders in the synagogue that came in to read the scripture. And Jesus came in, and what the religious leaders would do, y'all all right, y'all leave me alone. That's all right, I'm going to preach it anyway. Many of the religious leaders would come in, and they would read the scripture, and they would pick up the text where it had left off. Jesus goes into the synagogue, and the book is open to this particular passage of scripture, and it's right here, and it's Isaiah, the book of Isaiah, from the prophet Isaiah, and it said, and when he opened the book, he found this place where it was written. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, and there was delivered unto him this book, and he grabbed this book, and he began to say, he anointed me. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. They delivered this book. He grabbed the book. He said, he anointed me. He's anointed. He's anointed. No, to preach to those that find themselves in a broken place. He said, he anointed me to preach. So he sent me to heal the brokenhearted and preach deliverance to the captives, to heal the brokenhearted and preach deliverance to the captives. John 10:10 says, the thief cometh but not to steal, to kill, and destroy. He said, I come that they might have life and life more abundantly. Watch this. I'm so glad that Jesus said this, that they anointed me. I'm anointed. He came to open up a pathway so that we can live a guilt-free life. a life free of shame, a life free of rejection. Jesus came so that we can live guilt-free lives. Jesus came so that we can live quiet and peaceful lives. He said, they anointed me. I feel like preaching, y'all. Jesus came and he gave this, he read that reading and then he sat down and everybody looked at him. Why? Because they said this boy was anointed. What does this mean, Pastor? It means that Jesus, he didn't come. I hate to tell y'all this, but he didn't come for the perfect. I'm sorry to be the one to tell you that he did not come for the perfect people. He didn't come for the super saints. The super saints that never sinned, that got a scripture for everything. Never cussed, never fussed, never uttered a mumbling word. I'll stop by and tell you, he ain't come for you. Luke 4:18 says, Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He sent me to heal the brokenhearted. This is it right here, y'all, to heal the brokenhearted. Here it is, Antioch. Heal the brokenhearted. All the perfect saints, y'all can go on and tune out by now. Y'all can check out by now, say, oh, he ain't talking to me because, you know, I'm perfect. Go on, turn away. Go find you a perfect preacher. You may be looking for a while, though. Go on and find you some perfect saints to hang out with. Go on and find you some perfect kids to feed dinner to. But at the end of the day, you may find that you're going to be by yourself. It ain't a whole bunch of perfect. I only know one perfect person. His name was Jesus Christ. Watch this, y'all. Watch this, y'all. My message today is to encourage those who have been broken. Those who are living their lives, Sister Neil, in pieces. You wake up in the morning, you grab a piece here, and you grab a piece there, and you grab a piece here, you grab a piece there, and you put this piece on and that piece on, and you say, I just got to try to make it through the day. Pieces! Those who live their lives needing some fixing. Those that came to this broadcast, you feeling like your life is in these shattered pieces, I stopped by to tell you today that the fixer is here. Somebody write in the chat that the fixer is here. Come on, Jill, help me preach this thing. Write in the chat, the fixer is here. Somebody in the congregation say out loud, say the fixer is here. The fixer is here. The fixer is here. All right, write this down. Number one, here is the first point. Number one, I'm going to be okay. 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 The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives. The disciples and all that were present had their eyes fixated on Jesus, Sister Terry, and he was reading from the place of authority in the spirit realm. Those that heard him perceived that he was reading about himself. Watch this, y'all. The Spirit of the Lord has anointed me for this assignment. Jesus was the only perfect person that I know that walked the earth realm. The Bible says he that knew no sin was made to be sin. Everybody else, sinners. So watch this. Watch this. Watch this, mother. The rest of us are flawed individuals trying to fulfill calls upon our lives. Flawed individuals trying to feel the demand that is upon our lives. Somebody just say out loud, I'm going to be okay. All of us were born with flaws. Everybody got one eye bigger than the other eye, one foot bigger than the other foot. You go to the store to buy some shoes and you say, no, don't give me that. Don't bring that shoe. Bring me the other shoe. Why? Because this foot bigger than that foot. Come on, somebody. All of us have flaws. Some people have speech impediment. Some folks are just born with some character issues. but all of us are born with flaws. What's your flaw, Pastor? I love cars. Y'all leave me alone. But this is what I love about Jesus. Jesus said that I came to heal the brokenhearted. If we're honest, all of us are broken somewhere. We're the only ones that know where we're broken at. Come on, somebody else. Hallelujah. Watch this. Some folks can hide their brokenness better than other folks. The other day I was watching and I saw a great singer on, I think Celine Dion was her name, and I saw her on, and Celine Dion was out singing to thousands. She was singing to thousands. They was applauding, they was clapping, they was paying hundreds of dollars for tickets, but Celine was broken. Her husband was laying at home dying, and Celine was out singing. She was broken. Folk didn't know what she was crying about. She's singing a song, but she's crying. They think that she's just emotional about the song. She's broken. Here's our comfort, y'all. Jesus said, I came to heal the brokenhearted. The truth of the matter is, church is a place where broken folks gather. We gather in church. Why? To help one another through our brokenness. It's okay, brother. It's going to be all right. I've been there. It's okay, sister. God's going to heal you. I've been there. It's a place where misfits gather. Don't be ashamed of that. Don't let nobody talk you out of that. Don't let somebody talk you into thinking that you're perfect. The devil is a liar. You ain't perfect. We all got some flaws. And God uses us in spite of our many flaws. When the guards came to get Jesus to crucify him, mother, he was with a broken fella by the name of Peter. Peter got mad, pulled out his sword, Paula, and he sliced off the guard's ear. Broken! Jesus said, that's not what we're doing here. Not what we're doing here. Jesus grabbed the man and healed the man. But Peter showed you he was broken. He was just a man. I stopped by to encourage somebody's heart today that God knows that you're not perfect. You might fuss sometimes. You might even cuss sometimes. The saints don't know it because you can hide it real well. But your family knows, and they accept you anyway. God told me to tell you that he came for you too. Jesus said that he died for you too. He said that he came for your brokenness too. If you're broke, the fixer is here. Lift up your hands and just throw your hands up and surrender and say, Lord, I'm yours, fix me. Lord, I'm yours, fix me. Jesus said, I came to heal those that are broken. He didn't come for those that was already whole, but he came for those that were broken. The Bible says, cast your cares upon me because I care for you. Lay aside every weight and sin that so easily besets us. The weight is you carrying around your broken pieces. Somebody ought to say, thank you, Lord, for fixing me. Somebody say, it's going to be okay. It's going to be all right. Come on, Jesse, we're not tapping neighbors now. We just tap ourselves. Tap yourself and say out loud in your mask. Hopefully you got a mint. Just say out loud in your mask. Say, it's going to be okay. Hallelujah. I was walking around the outlet mall the other day with my wife and had my mask on. I said, man, something smells out here. Started looking around. It occurred to me, it's me. I need a mint. I need a mint. Y'all ain't saying no. See, that's why God used me. That's why God uses me, because he says, this one will stay humble. Come on. All right, right there. Number two, God loves me. Put that down, somebody. Say, God loves me. God loves me. Put that in the chat, somebody. God loves me. God loves me. Put that in the chat. God loves me. He sent me to heal the brokenhearted and preach deliverance to the captives. Jesus said, I came to preach deliverance to the captives. Watch this. I got to teach a little bit. Deliverance comes from this Greek word, elphaso. I had it good before I came. Elphaso, A-P-H-E-S-E-O-S, elphasos. And it means to cause one to stand away. It means to release one's sins from the sinner. It means forgiveness, or it means remission. In other words, deliverance was done by the finished work of Christ on the cross. Preach, Thomas. Our sin, or the sin of mankind, was hung on the tree called the cross. Jesus hung your sin on Calvary. Christ died so that we might live. Christ died so that he might remove the power of sin from your life. Sin has no more power over you. We are no longer sinners because we have been saved by grace through faith in Jesus Christ. So I say, we don't sin. I said, I didn't say you didn't sin. I said, you were not a sinner. A sinner is somebody that perpetually sins. You know, like a basketball player, you play basketball. Huh? Somebody that is whatever you do and you throw that ER on it, it just signifies what you do. Amen? Yeah, I'm not a sinner. Amen? I've been saved. Amen? Somebody write in the chat, I'm free. Write that in the chat. Write in the chat. Say, I'm free. I'm free. I'm free. We're free from the bondage of sin. That's what Jesus came back to do, to free us from the bondage of sin. Sin no longer has dominion over your life. No more shackles are holding you. Watch this. The devil will try to get you to focus on your flaws. People will try to get you to focus on your flaws. People will try to get you to focus on who you used to be. Folk might remember and say, I remember when you used to do this. I remember when you used to do that. Don't get all sanctimonious. Just say this. Yes, I did. I did. But God saved me. But God delivered me. Yes, I did. But God. Why? Because I serve a but God. Somebody might say, you know what? I used to be a hot ghetto mess, but God delivered me from it all. God has given me the power to repent. You got the power to repent. To repent means to turn and go the other way. I feel like preaching to somebody today. I know the world doesn't like it, but we serve a loving and a forgiving God. Pastor, you giving folks the license to sin. No, I'm not, but I'm giving the folks the license to be free. Because he set us free. All of us are ex-somethings, ex-liars, ex-backstabbers, some of us ex-thieves. We all ex-somethings, amen? I love seeing people that have been set free from abusive exes. You know, in my line of work, I see a lot of folk that were in abusive relationships. I love to see folk that get free from abusive exes. In the past, exes had power over them. Y'all ain't saying nothing. But now they've been set free. So now they walk in liberty. See, that cool, slick talk, it don't get to them no more. That good smelling cologne, it don't smell good no more. That used to be cool, handsome wine sipper now looks like an old wino. Louis the Lush. What changed? God set you free. Freedom has given them a different lens. Now they don't see life the same way no more. Somebody just say this out loud. Say, God has set us free. God has set us free. But just in case somebody catches you on a bad day. Y'all need to know something, that God is still a forgiver. 364 days out the year, you've been good. You've been upstanding. You've been the model Christian. But Jimbo messed around and caught you on the wrong day, at the wrong time. And you let Jimbo have some stuff that was embarrassing to the new you. Jimbo caught you and you cussed Jimbo like folk didn't know you had them combos in you. I stopped by to tell you today, just repent. God still loves you. I said, God still loves you. You and all your flaws. Every flaw, God loves you. All your shortcomings, God loves you. But this is what I need to tell you. Be quick to repent. Be quick to drop to your knees. Be quick to say, God, I'm sorry, Lord. I don't know what came over me. Lord, I was doing good, but it pushed me to the edge. Come on, somebody. Be quick to repent. You got to know that God loves you. Somebody might say, I fall short sometimes. I feel like preaching. I'm done, y'all. But God loves me. I might fall down sometimes, but God loves me. I might go into a little state of depression and have a pity party, but God still loves me. May not spend the money the way that I need to spend the money, but God still loves me. Shouldn't have bought this, shouldn't have bought that, but God still loves me. Come on, somebody. God still loves me. Shouldn't have talked to my baby father that way, but God still loves me. Shouldn't have talked to the kids that way, but God still loves me. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. That's why, when you got a repentant heart, that's why you're still standing. Somebody say it out loud. Say, I'm still standing. I'm still standing because God has prospered me. I'm still standing. I'm still standing because I got a repentant heart. I'm still standing because I know how to tell God I'm sorry. I'm still standing. That's why I'm walking in good health, because God said I can still use you. Somebody say it out loud. Say, I'm still standing. Tell somebody, say, don't count me out. I'm still standing. Yeah, Jimbo caught me on the last day, but I'm still standing. Yeah, I shouldn't have said that, but I'm still standing. I got some pieces. They broken. They shattered, but I'm still standing. God didn't put me together with some duct tape, some crazy glue, some gorilla glue, but I'm still standing. I feel like preaching to somebody today. Tell your neighbor, say, God is still fixing me. I'm not a finished product. He's still fixing me. I said, I'm not a finished product. He's still fixing me. When it's all said and done, I stop by to tell somebody today that you're going to be good as new. I said, you're going to be good as new. When you repent and you confess your sins unto the Lord, he looks at you and he wipes your slate clean. And he said, you're new, you're brand new today. I thank God that you're brand new today. That's why the Christian folk didn't cancel Kurt, because we got our own stuff we're dealing with. And God still uses us. The doors of the church are open. You can come as a candidate for baptism, or you can come on your own Christian experience. Amen. Sister Eugenia, listen, this is what I need to do. Come on, y'all, stand to your feet. I'm done. That's what I need to do. I just need everybody, wherever you are, sound of my voice. Please, before you click me off, share this with somebody. Share this with somebody. We have enough of y'all. I need 30 of y'all. Last week, y'all came up short. I need 30 of y'all. Let's meet the goal this week. I need 30 people to share this. 30 people to share this. You got somebody in your Facebook family, your Facebook group, that needs to know that God still loves them. Come on, don't be selfish. Don't be selfish. They need to know that God still loves them. They need to know that the sin that they got themselves into, that God can cover that. Jesus died for that sin too. Come on, stand to your feet. I'm done, y'all. Stand to your feet. Come on with me, First Lady. I'm done.
I'm just going to pray. I just want to pray with somebody today. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all. Lift your hands up, y'all. Just lift your hand up in the sanctuary today. I just want to pray with somebody today. Wherever you are today, come on, stand to your feet. Just lift your hand up wherever you are. I want to pray for you today. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for those that are under the sound of my voice today.
Yes, Father.
Those that found themselves, Lord God, feeling guilty about this or feeling guilty about that. Father, I pray that you remove that. Amen. Remove that weight as far as the east is from the west.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, they looked at their lives and they see all these broken pieces. But what they need to understand is that all of us have some broken pieces.
Yes.
Yeah. Our brokenness may be a little bit different than theirs. But Lord God, you are the potter.
Hallelujah.
Put us back together again.
Yes, God.
Make us whole, Lord God.
Yes, God.
Father, I pray for somebody today that you would make them whole today. I pray, Lord God, that you would free them from the bondage of sin.
My God.
Free them, Lord God.
Hallelujah.
Let them know, Lord God, that they are free. They've been set free. Yeah, there it is. I feel that weight coming off you right now. I feel that weight coming off you right
now.
I wish.
Thank you.
I feel that weight coming off you right now.
Jesus.
I feel that weight lifting from you right now.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It wasn't as bad as they said it was.
My God.
I feel that weight lifted off.
My God.
Come on, now lift your hands and just say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father, for removing that weight.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
I need to tell you this. Listen to me, saints of God, in the sanctuary and even in Facebook. I need to tell you this. Listen, the enemy will always try to have you live a life of guilt and shame.
Come on.
Lord has delivered you from that.
He has.
You've been delivered from that.
Yes.
Amen. And whenever those emotions, that feeling comes up, guilt and shame, whenever that comes up, just lift up your voice, because you fight through your word.
Yes.
It's the word of your testimony.
Yes, yes.
When that comes up, you just lift your voice and say, "The devil is a liar.
Amen.
I have been set free.
Yes.
From guilt to shame.
Amen.
God loves me." And just begin to say, "God loves
Thank
me.
You. Thank
God,
God,
you love me.
Thank you.
You kept me, Lord.
Thank you, God.
You're fixing me, Lord.
Hallelujah.
You love me, Lord.
Hallelujah.
You're fixing me, Lord.
Hallelujah.
You kept me, Lord."
Yes.
And then watch this. And then he says, "Resist the devil,"
yes,
"and he will flee."
He will flee.
And then them thoughts will flee.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you. Amen.
Praise
Hallelujah.
The
First
Lord.
Lady.
Amen. All I could think about is Jesus in the wilderness.
Yes.
And he fought with the word. Because the devil always want to tell you if you this, if you that. But Jesus teaches us that word of God,
yes,
will fight every battle.
Fight every battle.
And that's why I continue to say, agree with God and what he has said about us. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Powerful message,
agree,
Pastor.
Agree with God. Amen.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah.
Powerful message.
Hallelujah.
Ooh, they was preaching with you good today, boy.
Amen. Thank you so much. Listen, I thank y'all for coming.
Good.
Leaders, you can come on in if you want to. We have some leaders in here right now.
Amen.
You
God
all can come
all
in if
you
want to. Thank you guys so much for coming. Amen.
Love you so much.
I pray y'all felt safe and that we have taken all the precautions. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So now you can go to the grocery store, go grab you some food from the restaurant. Amen.
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 Our power. There
our
it
power.
Is.
That's it, y'all. That's all I have for today. Amen. Y'all good? I mean, all right. May the good Lord keep you. May heaven smile upon you. That is my prayer. Father, be with us as we leave and we go our separate ways.
Yes.
Touch us all as we agree.
Yes.
Lord God, thank you, Lord God.
Thank you.
For giving us the victory.
Yes.
Over sin.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless each and every one of you all.
Love y'all.